You know, we gotta tell a little story real quick, okay?
How's your diet? A lot of fiber.
I used to spend a lot of time reading about torture. I consider myself a little bit of a con. I believe that while our military forces and those in China and the Soviet Union have all pushed the train to an upper echelon, we can't be remiss and forget our past and forget some of those who were here long before us and their wonderful techniques. And for those of you who are uninitiated, of course, I'm speaking of the indigenous people, the Iroquois Indian of the upper New York Plains. Now they had some of the most wonderful torture techniques. And, well, you know, some of their lighter fare was such as taking a man and slicing the skin off the bottom of his feet. And then they'd take corn kernels and pack them in. And then they'd sew the skin back on with leather banding. And then they'd force them to run around a fire pit. And if they stopped running, they'd jab them with torches. It was pretty neat, I imagine. But that really pales in comparison to a rather vivid tale recorded by some of the early cavalry. You see, one time, the Iroquois Indian took hold of a man. They decided that they wanted to roast him over an open fire on a spit. Speaking of spit, you know, that doesn't smell like the stuff we were smelling last night. Anyways.
Yeah, that's right.
So this one lucky fella, he kind of won the lottery of hell, if you know what I mean.
Oh, yeah.
They put him, before they put him on the spit, they jammed about 4 or 5 pounds of raw meat up his ass. The story goes that it was bacon, for those of you who've got a preference. So they jammed some, I'm guessing, peppercorn bacon up his ass. And then they tied him off to a spit and left him there to roast overnight. Well, now, given that this group, this band of Iroquois, had some predilection to the imbibing of certain alcohol grain beverages, they passed out. And this lucky fella, you know what he got to do? He got to get free. He got to get free. But the fun part of the story is that he was about 5 or 6 miles away from his home camp, and it was freezing ass cold, and it was snow everywhere. He was gonna die anyways, except for the lucky lunch pail of his anus. He actually lived on the trek back to the camp by eating the meat out of his own ass. You feel like reaching over and hugging somebody that you're standing next to, embracing them and just thanking God to be alive, and that there's probably fast food nearby here, but I don't know what will. And as a very nice, tidy segue, we will go from one song or story about pulling meat out of your ass to my personal favorite story about putting meat into somebody's ass. And it's the last of my anal fetish songs, okay? I promise.
You're talking about ass fucking!
Wagon in your round street.
might even bleed you my universe. I'll stab your back crack with my boxer. What you hide in the back, you can't be ignored.
Thank you.